Welcome back. We're speaking with Ashish Hemrajani of BookMyShow. As an entrepreneur, you've been through the boom and the bust period of the internet industry. What are the mistakes that you will not want to repeat?
I have made no mistakes. They're all learnings. Because if you are truly an entrepreneur, then none of those can be mistakes. Because the day you say that they were mistakes, then you'll stop being an entrepreneur. They're learnings. We launched our business very early before its time. And I think one learning that we had was that the market wasn't ready for our business. So when we launched in 1999, and I think we scaled very rapidly the ecosystem for credit cards, debit cards, net banking, payments didn't exist. People didn't have cell phones with data connectivity. So we were running 7 call centers. We were the first company in the world which did home delivery and cash on delivery. Today you see all these companies doing cash on delivery. We were the first from 1999 to 2002 to offer that. And the beauty about the internet business is that your cost curve needs to flatten as your revenue curve goes up. And our cost curve kept following our revenue curve, right? So we could never disengage or break that or unshackle that sort of trend. So even when you see some of the businesses that we are launching on the live side, on the audio streaming and digital radio, or whether it's to do with snackable videos, we're trying to time it right. And we don't want to be early before its time, where we lose a lot of money. We think the time is now. And that's why we've launched it. We could have launched it 2 years ago or 4 years ago. So it's all about timing. It's about love, right? When you tell a girl something and you've got to time it right, right? And you could say the same thing at a very inappropriate moment and get slapped. Or she could say yes to you. So I think timing is important in business as it is in life.
Is it becoming far easier for startups to ride the ecosystem these days?
Well, from a financing point of view, yes. From an advice point of view, yes. From an incubation point of view, yes. But I still think that a lot of entrepreneurs end up making a lot of mistakes because they're reading media, they're watching media, and it's being overhyped in terms of get rich fast, valuations, billions of dollars, awards that are being handed out. And I think it's not good for the ecosystem. And why just the internet? Why aren't people thinking of brick and mortar businesses? Why aren't they thinking of renewable energy businesses? Why aren't they thinking of social enterprise businesses for profit? I think there is so much there that needs to be built in this country, which is not built. Internet or online is just not the only way to build a business. I just wish that there were more entrepreneurs doing loads of other stuff.
I can't not talk to you about your work-life balance and your passion for sailing. Tell us about it. Tell us about how you make the time to go out sailing and be an active sailor.
I certainly take time off on Saturdays. I race sailboats on Saturdays. I've been doing so for 15 years. I have a Hansi 325 and we've got a great sailing community out there. I spend time at least 3 times a week. I try and make it to the gym or swim. I spend time with the family. I take 3 or 4 vacations a year. We encourage people to take vacations. You learn so much when you're actually taking time off because you absorb and observe so much more from the world around you, which you can actually plow back into your daily jobs. So I think it's very important to be able to do that.
And I read somewhere that you want to go sailing with Mr. Tata. Is that true?
Well, a lot of people ask you who are your heroes that you look up to, right? And for me, it's really been Steve Jobs, who's not there. He's somewhere on the iCloud. You know, I've read his book many times over. I think he's just phenomenal. I think what Elon Musk does is outstanding. I really value, what Jeff Bezos has done. I mean, these are phenomenal icons in the world out there. And people ask me who else, and I look at an Indian icon and I think with integrity, with morality, as well as poise and dignity, if somebody has turned around businesses and built incredible value, has been Ratan Tata. And I happened to bump into him once when I was sailing to Mandwa. It was a race and I was crossing over on one of the boats and he had just won the Asian Business Time Award of the Year or something like that. And we were crossing and I congratulated him and he thanked me for it. I mean, you know, he's just a simple guy. I've seen him at airports, carry his own bag, stand in the line. And I think that is incredibly humble. He's humane and there's a value attached to that. And I think if all of us can follow in those footsteps, we'd be a better business community.
All right, on that note, I'm going to do a quick rapid fire with you. Are you ready? Brace yourself.
I'm not, but if you insist.
Your favorite movie?
Cinema Paradiso.
Hollywood or Bollywood?
Hollywood.
Your inspiration or role model? Only one this time.
Steve Jobs.
Your top business mantra?
More companies die out of indigestion than starvation.
A character from a book that you'd like to associate yourself with?
Obelix.
Why so?
Invincible. Magic potion and smash anybody that you want.
Book My Show 5 years from now.
Loved by every single Indian.
An entrepreneur or a sailor?
Lessons from both. Cannot disconnect one from the other.
All right. On that note, thank you so much for joining us. It's really been
thank
a pleasure speaking with you today.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Time now to wrap this very special edition. Thank you so much for watching.